Okay, so this is how we're going to be testing the panels today. I have this white table angled properly at the sun. I did use the can trick to align it and face it towards the sun so we have no shadow. Down here, I have a piece of wood so that when you put the panel here, the grass does not shade the panel. And then on the back here, underneath, I have my 100 amp hour battery and my MPPT solar charge controller. So we're going to be able to plug these in one after the other, see the maximum output, and then move on to the next panel. Now, as for solar conditions today, it's around 100 degrees, so these panels will get warm. We have a few clouds, but I've kind of let them pass and just a little bit of haze. Okay, this is the ATEM solar. We're seeing 17.7 volts output, 4.5 amps, right around 80 watts. Partial shading results for the ATEM solar, we are getting basically zero power. Okay, so with the Big Blue, we're seeing right around 95 watts of output. That's 17.6 volts and 5.6 amps. You can see it's jumping around just a little bit here. Did peak at 97. Okay, so with the Big Blue, we're seeing right around 48 watts with partial shading. Okay, results on the BLUERISE 120 watt panel. We're seeing 102 watts, 18.69 volts, 5.4 amps. Partial shading results for the BLUERISE solar, about 50% of the power at 51 watts. Okay, with the Xtar, we're seeing right around 120 watts. That's 16.4 volts at 7.5 amps, guys. This thing's putting out a ton of power right now, 123 watts. Partial shading results on the Xtar SP100. We're seeing 1.7 watts, so not very good with partial shading. Okay, this is the Swari 100 watt panel, seeing 18.8 volts, 4.17 amps, right around 78 watts. The partial shading results on the Swari are right around 36 to 37 watts. Okay, with the Dokyo, we're seeing right around 91 watts. It's right around 16.3 volts at 5.28 amps. Okay, testing the Dokyo in partial shading, we're seeing right around 30 watts. Now we did have some clouds run in just this last minute here, but at least this is still putting out power when it's under partial shading conditions. So that tells us that both halves are wired together in parallel. For example, guys, look at these clouds. They just came in so fast. It's so frustrating when you have a clear day, you're doing all this testing, it's 100 degrees, you're sweating so much to test these panels out, and then clouds roll in so you can't finish your testing. Luckily, this is kind of the last panel that I wanted to test, and we did get some good results. In perfect sunshine, I was seeing right around 92 watts, and then we saw it dipping down right at the very end there, and with partial shading, we still saw power output. The only panels that I wanted to test were my SunPower Flex 50s because those are great panels as well. So let me just go ahead and put these up here. I'll just show you what they look like. But yeah, we're not going to see maximum power on them. Okay, these results might not mean much, but we're seeing around 15 volts, 2 amps at around 30 watts in complete cloud cover. Now I usually see right around 100 watts from these panels. Let me go ahead and see if I can find some footage of me testing these in the past, and I'll throw it on the screen. Okay guys, we're gonna go ahead and test my SunPower Flex 50s in parallel. Now these usually produce right around 49 to 50 watts in perfect conditions. Let's see what we're getting today. Okay, so we're seeing about 94 to 95 watts input on these SunPower cells. It's right around 16.2 volts at 5.8 amps. Now obviously, because these are two panels put together in parallel, if you partially shade one of them, you're gonna see around 50% of the output. So no issues when you have two of these in partial shade. Okay guys, that was a ton of work in the super hot sun. Now most of these panels we were able to test in really good, perfect sunshine. We had this shade come in a little bit on the Dokyo just at the very end. and then on the SunPower Flex 50s. Now just to go over each of the panels one more time, we have the BLUERISE, the Swari, the Big Blue, the ATEM Solar, the Xtar SP100, the Dokyo, and the SunPower Flex 50s. Let's go ahead and get all the information that we just gathered, put it together, and see what the results are. Okay guys, I've taken a couple of days to analyze all the performance on these panels, and I've come up with two separate graphs to show us visually how they compare. So the first graph is to show us the maximum power output per panel, and the second graph is to show us the cost per watt basis to give us an idea of which one provides the best value. So let's go ahead and throw these graphs on the screen so you guys can see how they performed. Now taking a look at the first graph, this is the maximum power output. You have the maximum power on the left and the lowest on the right. Now the Xtar came in first place with 123 watts, which is pretty far above all the others. The BLUERISE coming in at second place with 102 watts. The SunPower Flex 50s in parallel put out 98 watts. The Big Blue, 97. The Dokyo, which is the cheapest panel, put out a respectable 92 watts. And the ATEM Power comes in at 80 and the Swari at 78. Now, if you're looking for the maximum amount of power out of one solar panel, you're gonna wanna stick to the left-hand choices on this graph. Now, taking a look at the second graph here is a cost per watt basis, where I took the total cost of the solar panel and divided by the performance, and that gave us the cost per watt. Now, the Dokyo is the cheapest panel, but still put out 92 watts, so it comes out to be around $1.45 per watt. The BLUERISE gave us the second most amount of power and is pretty affordable, so that one comes in at $1.55. That's the one I would recommend here. The Big Blue, which is pretty decent, comes in at $1.95 per watt. The Swari is $1.98. The SunPower Flex 50s, $2.04. The Xtar, which is pretty pricey, this one comes with an additional charger at this price, which comes in at $2.26 per watt. And the ATEM Power, which is just a horrible value, comes in at $2.47 per watt. Now, I know there's a lot of information here, but if we take the information from both of those graphs and kind of combine it together, we can come out with three separate winners. The first one being which panel is the cheapest, meaning that if you have a very limited budget and you just want a solar panel to put out power, that's the panel you're going to want to choose. The next one is a balance between power and cost, which is the best value. So we'll come out with a winner on the best value. And the third one is if you're looking for the maximum amount of power, which panel are you gonna wanna choose? So let's go ahead and talk about the three winners in each of those categories. Okay, so starting with the cheapest panel. So if you have a limited budget and you just wanna buy a solar panel to get into solar, this is gonna be your cheapest folding option. Now this is the Dokyo 110. It comes in at $134 and it put out around 92 watts of power. Now this is a PET coating, so it's not quite as nice as some of the more expensive panels that you get ETFE coating. This won't last quite as long. It'll kind of fade and crack if it has direct contact with the sun for a very long period of time. Now it terminates in SAE, and you basically have a ton of different cables and adapters this comes with. The first main cable is probably about 10 feet long. It has SAE to XT60, so this will plug right into an EcoFlow product. And then it has an XT60 to a barrel plug here. So then you can plug it into basically any power station that takes a barrel plug. Now these barrel adapters are 8mm or 7909, 5521, 5525, and even the smaller ones. So very compatible with a lot of different power stations. The other thing is this comes with an actual PWM charge controller. It's a cheap charge controller, but it should work. And it comes with the alligator clips and everything to plug it in. So for the price, this is an excellent option. It is a little bit bigger, and that just probably means the solar panels aren't quite as efficient. It's a little bit flimsy, but for $134 and all the accessories it comes with, it'd still be a great way to start out with solar. So this is the Dokyo 110, and it's the cheapest option. Now, the next panel that we're gonna be looking at in the video today is what I consider to be one of the best value options, meaning it puts out a decent amount of power and it still comes in at a great price. This is the BLUERISE 120 watt panel. It's definitely an upgrade over the Dokyo 110. For example, this has an ETFE coating, which is gonna last longer and be more durable than a PET coating. And this panel also comes with two adjustable kickstands on the back, meaning you can angle it properly at the sun to get that little bit of extra power. Now, I like that it has these large green handles that have magnets in it. So when you fold up the panel, the magnets actually hold it closed, which is pretty cool. And on the back, you have three USB ports. You have two quick charge USB-A ports, and you have one USB-C port, and the manual states it's rated for 24 watts maximum output.
Now you also have a ton of other connections here. You have an Anderson power pole connection. You have a DC to DC charging cable that plugs into a power station that has a barrel connector and a lot of other barrel connector adapters. And then what's awesome is you have an MC4 style cable. In case you need MC4 connections, you can plug whatever you want directly into these to charge up your device. So this is an excellent option if you're looking for a good build quality and decent amount of power at a great price. Now the last panel that we're going to take a deep dive into is the panel that put out the most power. Now this is the Xtar SP100. It put out a total of 123 watts, which was 21 watts more than the second place panel. So you do get a lot more power here. Now usually you have to pay a lot more money for that level of efficiency. This uses SunPower cells, and this comes at a price of $250 or $269, depending on which options you go with. This has a really nice ETFE coating. It's durable, it's not gonna scratch, it's fully waterproof. And on the back, you get the adjustable kickstands. You have the handles that are magnetic. And I've used this for about a year now on multiple camping trips during rainstorms, and it still keeps going. So I have full confidence that this is a waterproof panel. But you have a couple different power options. You have a long 14 gauge cable, it's about 10 feet long, and you get an 8mm style connector here. And you have an 8mm to MC4 connection if you want to use MC4 connections for whatever you're trying to charge. So if you want the most amount of power out of a solar panel, you're going to pay a little bit more for it, but this is the Xtar SP100 for 123 watts. Now, before I go farther into the video, I just want to let you guys know that this is not a paid advertisement for any of these companies. These are the three that stuck out to me the most. Now we're going to go ahead and talk about the other panels, but I did purchase 5 of the 7 of these panels. The only panels that were sent out for review was the Xtar about a year ago and the Big Blue panel about 6 months ago. So the first panel that we're going to talk about and just give you guys some information is the SunPower Flex 50. This is an extremely lightweight panel. It's paper thin, it's slightly flexible, and these are fully waterproof. So if you're looking for something extremely lightweight and waterproof and puts out really good power, this is your option. Now, we just didn't see a ton of power output from this. This is a 50 watt panel, puts out around 49 watts. Now, I do have 2 of these. I use them all the time. I like how they are fully waterproof, but the only downside is they do scratch. I have a few scratches on here, and it doesn't really affect the output, but it's just not quite as durable as an ETFE flexible panel, but these are a great option. Now, the next panel that I briefly want to talk about is this Swari panel. Didn't see good output from this. The pricing wasn't amazing. I just would say pass on this panel. I'm not super happy with it. The next panel is the Big Blue panel. This one's kind of right down the middle of the pack. This one has a really good feel to it. Very good, very rigid. ETFE coating. I like the handles on it. It doesn't take up much space. It's pretty lightweight. So if you could find this one at a good price, it'd be very similar to the BLUERISE solar panel, because this one came out with 97 watts and is priced around $190 to $180. So a little bit more than the BLUERISE, but very good quality on the BLUERISE, on the Big Blue. Now, the failure of all the panels was this one. This comes in at $200 and put out 80 watts or 78 watts. No, it was 80 watts. So this one comes in with the worst performance for the price. It basically looks like the Xtar SP100. It's basically like a clone, but they must have gotten like secondhand quality SunPower cells, because this does not put out nearly as much power as the Xtar SP100, even though it's almost identical. So even though it looks like this, guys, it doesn't mean it has the high quality cells in it. These must be like grade B cells or something, because we saw 123 watts on the Xtar and 80 watts on this one. That is like 43 watts difference, and the price of this panel is just $50 less than the Xtar. So don't be fooled by panels that look like this, because they probably won't be putting out the same amount of power. So you usually have to pay for the power, guys. You can't get a budget panel that looks like this and it still put out power. So interesting results, right? Hopefully you guys found all this information helpful in comparing these panels. Now, this video is meant to be mostly about these bifold panels, but there are a lot of other portable panels out there. There are quadfold panels, which are excellent. The Elecanta or the Balder 120 are excellent options. If you can't find any of these at a good price, check out the Elecanta 120 or the Balder 120. These are ETFE panels. They put out around 113 watts. I've Lots of use with these panels. I've had lots of people purchase them. I know they are good, and you can also find those on Amazon. Now, just one thing that you should know, if you're gonna be using these panels on a daily basis, you know, every single day, over and over again, I'd recommend not going with a portable panel, but going with a glass rigid panel. They're less expensive, they last a lot longer, they're gonna last 25 years, they're not gonna have, you know, any issues with them. If you want to go with a portable setup like this, these are meant for temporary power outages, camping, portable needs, things like that. But these aren't meant to stand up to you know, the sun over and over and over again for years and years and years like a glass rigid panel is. These will fade, they're gonna get damaged from the sun's rays. The PET is gonna break down a lot faster than the ETFE, but just be aware, you're gonna get a longer life out of panels that are glass rigid panels. So I recommend that if you're going with a permanent setup like in your backyard or something or on a roof, go with glass rigid panels. So we're basically coming to the end of the video. Covered everything that I wanted to talk about with these panels. Now I will have the links to these panels down in the video description if you're interested in picking one up. Now I'd love to hear your guys' feedback. Have you guys purchased any of these panels or used them? Throw a comment down below. Let me know what your experience has been with any of the panels in this video. Now please give me a thumbs up if you like the content, guys. It always helps out the channel. Also, if you haven't subscribed, I invite you guys to subscribe to the channel because I have a lot of really cool stuff coming out in the future and you don't want to miss it. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you guys in the next video.